What's going on, America? This is Kevin in Kevin's Corner, and I was watching an interview with the guy who's running for, I think, governor of Florida, Gilliam, the guy who claims he doesn't understand the context in which Ron DeSantis was referring to monkeying around. I mean, this is the same guy who can't understand the basic sentence structure and how it shifts from one context to another. But he's on some show giving an interview. It might even been a liberal station, giving an interview about democratic socialism and about health care. And he's given this wild, you know, ridiculous claim that, you know, we're going to go ahead and we're going to make sure that everybody has health care in Florida. And the lady was like, well, how are you going to do that? Is it true that you're going to raise the taxes for corporations? And he tried to dodge the question. He was, you know, he was hopscotching for a second, like one, two, one, in and out. And she finally pinned him down. You know, how you gonna do that without raising taxes? Well, I mean, taxes will have to go up, but you know, overall, we're gonna save money. This is what I mean about no details and a roundabout explanation that makes no logical sense. Matter of fact, I think I might as well just go ahead and run for office as a democratic socialist so I don't have to actually put together a presentation. I don't have to come up with real practical plans, no answers. You can just ask me stuff and I'll just throw wild accusations out. Hey, you know, hey, Kevin, how are you going to deal with crime? See, the way we're going to deal with crime is we're not going to deal with it. As a democratic socialist, we understand that the laws that have been put in place to stop crime is oppressive to criminals. And see, we're all about making sure that everybody is treated fairly, whether you're a criminal or you are a law defender. I mean, everybody is on an equal playing ground under democratic socialism. So, you know, the question you have to ask yourself is, what is crime? Is crime not in the eye of the beholder? I mean, look, if you're broke, okay, and you need money to feed your family, is robbing a bank a crime to you, or is it a way to survive? Simple as that. Thank you. No more questions. But wait, we got one more question. What about how are you going to pay for all of this medical that you're talking about, medical for everybody and free education? I'm glad you asked that question, and I would love to answer it, but just not logically. Okay? The way that we're going to do that is that we're going to invoke leprechauns and unicorns. See, I didn't want to break this out right now, you know, before the debate, but we've been working on a plan to track down the only remaining leprechaun. Once we do that, he'll lead us to his pot of gold, and then we'll be able to finance all of these social programs that we're talking about, okay? Does that make sense to you? I mean, since you're just drilling me and trying to lock me down to something, you know, I mean, matter of fact, I think the reason you're asking me this is because you're probably racist and you're probably a commie. And you're probably a sexist and a xenophobe and a homophobe. That's probably what you are. So by you even asking me this, I'm offended. It's not fair to my feelings that you're asking me tough questions that I'm responsible for answering for the American people and making it sound practical. You know what? It's disturbing. And you really need to check yourself. You know what? I can't do this anymore. I'm about to leave. I got to go. And so that is how the democratic socialists just operate. And if that's all it takes, man, I could have ran for office like 25 years ago. You know, it's kind of like these modern day rappers that be out there with the trap music. And I hear songs that just repeats itself over and over again. I heard a song back in the day, this was about 2 years ago. It was a song that's playing. And literally, the man kept saying, I'm in love with the cocoa. I've got it on the low low. And then the hook was baking soda. I've got baking soda. Now, I'm thinking to myself, if I would have known that's all it takes to drop a rap album and can make millions, I would have dropped one 25 years ago. If I didn't have to put no content in it, make it rhyme, you know, I didn't have to tell a story or make it make sense. I could just start repeating the same thing over and over again, even though it doesn't make sense, because the minds of this generation and a lot of people walking around, they don't want that content. They don't want substance. It's just, that's why they call it trap music. It traps you in, and as you just sitting there going to the beat, and you don't care what they're saying. You don't care. You're just listening to the beat. Same thing with the Democratic Party, and especially Democratic Socialism. They just get out there and say nice, wonderful sounding things. You know, how are you going to deal with all of the violence in America? Ice cream. We're going to pass out ice cream to everybody. Ice cream. Everybody loves ice cream. Distracted by that stuff. You know, just throwing out wild accusations. And you wonder why they got beat up a couple weeks ago. And I hope they get destroyed in November, along with the rest of the Democrats who really probably are the same way, but they can't say it. You know, they at least got enough wits to know that there's a large portion of Americans that are still moderates, even though they're Democrats. You know, they're like, man, you dude, you can't go out there talking reckless like that. You telling them we're going to just take all their money? What's your plan? How you going to do? How you going to pay for this? We're going to actually take all the money from the middle class and the upper class. And then we're going to take your money and we're going to distribute it equally amongst everybody, whether they want to work or not. It doesn't matter. We just think that we should control the flow of cash and just, you know, dispense it the way we feel it should be dispensed. And if you vote for us, we'll go ahead and start off with something called democratic socialism. But I'll be honest with you, because I'm transparent, it's really socialism. It's really socialism. You know, I'm trying to be honest with my constituents. So it's socialism, okay? And then eventually, as we gain control and power, and we start doing things like, you know, abolishing ICE, attacking the First and the Second Amendment. After we start doing those things, yeah, because see those things under socialism, we know how to make it sound fluffy, you know? Why would you want guns all around when people can get killed from guns? Don't you want people to live? You don't want people to die, do you? Then let us go ahead and just get some gun policies going to get those off the street for you, okay? Yeah, see, did it sound bad? No. So why would you resist something like that? You know, and then what about, you know what else? You know what else bothers us as socialists? Okay, and we're just going to deal with it, okay? You're asking me, what about freedom of speech? Huh? Your First Amendment? Well, guess what? We believe that everybody should be free to speak whatever we want them to speak. You know, that's all we're saying. We're just saying that you have to be sensitive to our message. That's all we're saying. And once you understand that, we won't have any problems. But all the rest of those misogynists, homophobes, xenophobes, and racists, and sexists, and all of those traitors out there, yeah, those guys, that's not freedom of speech, okay? Freedom of speech is not saying things that are opposite to us. What that's called? Hate speech. And it incites violence and it hurts people way down on the inside. So we can't have that. Do you want people making people hurt on the inside? Maybe it's me. Maybe you like to hurt people on the inside, but we don't. Not here. Over here in socialism, no. We don't like that. Everybody should be happy in socialism. Okay? Now, do you find anything wrong with that? Good. Now let's paint rainbows. Okay? Good. I'm going to go get some Lucky Charms. We're going to paint the rainbows. Everybody sit around. We're going to meditate for a while with our shoes off. Okay? Anyway. Got to do something about it in November, y'all. Come out and vote. We got to make this happen. This is the most important one. I'm telling you. Most important one. We hanging on to America and what it stands for. So God bless you. Find me Facebook, Twitter. Check me out on Wednesday nights, 7:30. My live radio blog talk show. And also, if you want to donate to Kevin's Corner, there's links in the bottom to do that as well. All right. God bless you. See you next time at Kevin's Corner.